So we have understood about the basics of potentiometry. How do we represent the potentiometric electrochemical cell? How do we schematically depict the electrochemical cell? And how do we systematically write the electrochemical cell assembly, which is containing indicator electrodes and reference electrodes along with the salt bridge, which can be used during the analysis of any sample. So normally, the electrochemical cell which will be used in potentiometry require indicator electrodes and reference electrodes. Indicator electrodes and reference electrodes. Indicator electrodes are also called as working electrodes. Indicator electrodes are also called as working electrodes. Any change in the concentration of the analyte is responded by only the indicator electrode. Reference electrode is not going to do anything with respect to the concentration of the analyte into which you have immersed that. So you take any electrochemical cell, it will be containing indicator electrode and the reference electrode. There is any change in the concentration of the analyte that is going to be responded by the indicator electrode. So the change in concentration of the analyte is attributed by the indicator electrode. And the role of the reference electrode, you know, the role of reference electrode is only to close the circuit of the electrochemical cell and in order to provide a reference potential against which the potential of the indicator electrode is going to be measured during the electrochemical analysis. So we have understood about the types of the reference electrodes in our previous discussions or in previous lectures. So let us understand about the indicator electrodes. So what are the commonly used indicator electrodes in potentiometry? How do we classify the indicator electrodes? So let us discuss one by one. In the indicator electrodes, we may use metallic indicator electrodes. We may use ion selective electrodes under the class of membrane electrodes. We may use biosensors. We may use chemosensors. We may use gas sensors, whatever it is. The proposed objective will be met by all these indicator electrodes. It may be metallic indicator electrode, or it may be membrane indicator electrode. It may be ion selective electrode. It may be gas sensing electrode. It may be biosensing electrode, whatever it is. The objective which is proposed while designing the indicator electrode must be completely met in order to accept that particular indicator electrode for the work by potentiometric method. So metallic indicator electrodes are the important class of indicator electrodes which are not commonly employed for the analysis of non-metallic species, but they are commonly or widely employed for the determination of metallic species when the metals are present in sample solutions. So metallic indicator electrodes, as the name is implying, they are made by metals. They are metallic electrodes. Metallic indicator electrodes are metallic electrodes. They are used to determine the concentration of the metallic species present in the sample solution. The metal may be present in a charged state or uncharged state. Anionic species may be present or cationic species may be present. If anionic species present, its concentration can be calculated in respect to the cationic metal which is associated with that anionic species. So these metallic indicator electrodes are falling in three classes. Metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind, metallic indicator electrodes of the second kind, and metallic indicator electrodes of the third kind. So metallic indicator electrodes are used to determine the concentration of a metal or any anion which is in coordination with this particularly charged metal species. So these metallic indicator electrodes are classified into three categories: metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind, the second kind, and third kind. We seldom use metallic indicator electrodes of the third kind for their nomenclature. They are commonly called as redox electrodes, inert redox electrodes. So let us discuss one by one what is the meaning of metallic indicator electrodes and what are the species going to be determined by this particular electrode. Similarly, metallic indicator electrodes of the second kind and the redox electrodes. Let me consider first the metallic indicator electrode of the first kind. Metallic indicator electrode of the first kind. You assume you take the copper sulfate solution or copper chloride solution in a beaker, and you immerse a copper rod into that particular beaker which is containing its ionic solution. copper rod has been immersed into copper sulfate solution or copper chloride solution, into which copper rod has been immersed, and this solution and this electrode is going to create one particular off cell of an electrochemical cell, and the remaining off cell will be the reference electrode. If you take any electrochemical cell, that will be containing reference electrode and the indicator electrode. Here the indicator electrode is going to be copper electrode, and the solution into which the indicator electrode has been immersed is the copper sulfate solution, the copper chloride solution, or copper nitrate solution, whatever it is. So since this electrode is called as indicator electrode, always in potentiometry, by convention, the indicator electrode will be called as a cathode, because reference electrode will be playing a role of anode, and hence the indicator electrode will be playing a role of cathode. So cathode is an electrode at which always reduction takes place. So what is the species responsible to undergo reduction process here? Elemental copper do not undergo reduction because its charge is already zero. It is a non-valent copper. It should not undergo reduction. The only species present in the solution is copper 2. So therefore, that should undergo reduction. And the reduction reaction can be depicted in this manner. So divalent copper present in the aqueous solution captured two electrons. These two electrons are obtained by the oxidation of the species from the reference electrode side. And two electrons are going to be captured by the divalent copper in order to convert this divalent copper to elemental copper. This is called as a reduction reaction. If you write the Nernst equation for this, E cell means the electrochemical potential for this particular off reaction. This is only off reaction. This is not a complete reaction of an electrochemical cell. So for this off reaction, if you write the Nernst equation, E cell is going to be the standard state reduction potential of copper 2 copper couple minus 0.05916 divided by 2 into log of 1 over concentration of Cu2 plus. This you know how to write the Nernst equation, for any redox reactions. Okay, here these two indicates there are two electrons have been added to copper 2 plus. The value of N will be equal to 2 here because two electrons have been added to copper 2 plus. So from the electrochemical series, you can have the value of the standard state reduction potential for copper 2 to copper, that is plus 0.3419 volts. So E value is equal to plus 0.3419 minus 0.05916 divided by 2 into log of 1 over copper 2 plus concentration. If you look at this equation, this means to say that when you immerse the copper electrode into copper ion solution, the other half of the electrochemical cell is containing the reference electrode. The potential of the reference electrode is always known. You know the potential of the reference electrode. You know the potential of this particular off reaction that can be measured while performing the potentiometric analysis. What the potentiometer is showing is nothing but E cell. That is nothing but E cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. E anode value you know, E cell value you know, so you can simply calculate the E value. Even if you know the value of E cell for this particular off cell, you can easily determine the concentration of copper 2 plus. So this is how the metallic electrodes are used. And here I have represented a simple systematic representation of this particular electrochemical cell as a whole, which is used to depict the presentation of the indicator electrode, metallic indicator electrode of the first kind, which is constructed by using copper rod. So this is the other off cell. This is the another off cell. In the left off cell, the reference electrode is used, that is saturated calomel electrode. There is a double slash present. This indicates the presence of the salt bridge between this copper and the saturated calomel electrode solutions into which these electrodes have been immersed. So after the salt bridge has an interface of copper 2 plus solution and the frit of the salt bridge, the unknown concentration of copper 2 plus we are going to determine. We don't know the concentration of copper 2 plus. Therefore, we have to use copper rod as a electrode. So when you use copper, to determine the concentration of copper 2 plus, This particular metallic electrode is called as metallic indicator electrode of the first kind. So not only copper, you take any metal, you take silver, you take bismuth, you take zinc, you take cadmium, you take lead, you take bismuth, whatever. So a particular metallic electrode is used to determine the concentration of the metallic ion, the same metallic ion. Then that type of electrodes are called as metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind. So you know the value of the potential from the indicator electrode, potential of the reference electrode, liquid junction potential you can determine, or you can fix the magnitude of the liquid junction potential. By convention, you can have the overall potential easily is equal to potential of the indicator electrode minus potential of the reference electrode plus ELJP. So this is EC and this is going to be EA. So you can simply substitute the value of E indicator electrode, you know, from the previous equation what we have written here. So you can bring that particular equation into the place of E indicator, that is plus 0.3419 minus 0.05916 divided by 2 into log of 1 over concentration of copper 2 plus minus the reference electrode potential is going to be plus 0.2444 volts. This is a standard value. For any reference electrode, it may be standard hydrogen electrode, it may be saturated calomel electrode, it may be silver silver chloride electrode. Out of these three, the reference electrode potential will be constant at particular temperature, but this value will be subject to variation at different temperatures. And this is obtained at 25 degrees Celsius. At 25 degrees Celsius, the reference electrode potential for saturated calomel electrode will be plus 0.2444 volts. And ELJP, if you know, you can substitute. Otherwise, you may have to determine the ELJP. If the ELJP is made to be zero by adjusting experimental conditions in such a way that there is no any additional potential generated during the electrochemical operation, in that cases, ELJP will become zero. So you can put here zero and you can go ahead to calculate the value of E cell. If you know the E cell from the potentiometer, what it is showing, you can easily calculate the value of copper 2 plus. Let us demonstrate how do we calculate the concentration of copper 2 plus later. So according to these discussions, finally we can define metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind. How do we define the metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind? Metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind are metallic indicator electrodes which are used to immerse into the solution containing its own ion. Copper has been immersed into copper ion solution, where we are going to determine the concentration of copper ion only. So these type of electrodes are called as metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind. So generally, if we write, generally, E cell is equal to K minus 0.05916 divided by N into log of 1 over Mn plus concentration. Here, Mn plus is the metal ion solution. Metal ion solution, the charge species of the metal, and the electrode which is going to be used will be M. The electrode which is going to be used will be M. So, the electrode M has been immersed into a solution containing Mn plus ion of concentration unknown, where the concentration of Mn plus is going to be determined by using the metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind, that is M. These type of electrodes are called as metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind. So where K represents the reference electrode potential, liquid junction potential, K is the summation of reference electrode potential and the liquid junction potential. N is going to tell you how many electrons have been transformed in the reduction process, such as Cu2 plus plus 2 electrons going to give you Cu, where the value of N is 0. So like that, the value of N can be substituted by having the number of electrons added to the ionic species. So finally, K plus 0.05916 divided by N into log of Mn plus concentration. So this is in the form of log 1 minus log Mn plus concentration. Log 1 will be 0. So minus into minus, you are going to get plus. So E cell is equal to K plus 0.05916 divided by N into log of concentration of metal ion Mn plus. So by convention, we can simply define The metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind is that it is a metallic indicator electrode M which is immersed into the solution Mn plus. Its concentration is going to be determined by potentiometry. That's what the metallic indicator electrode of the first kind. Normally, for silver, bismuth, cadmium, copper, mercury, lead, tin, thallium, and zinc, all these metals are used to construct metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind. Whenever we wanted to determine the concentration in the aqueous solutions of these pieces, silver ion, it may be bismuth ion, cadmium ion, copper ion, mercury, lead ion, tin, thallium, zinc, whatever among these metals which is present in the aqueous solution of the sample, their concentration can be easily determined by using the respective electrodes. If you are going to determine silver ion concentration, you have to use silver metal electrode. If you are going to use lead ion concentration, you have to use lead metal as a metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind. Of course, they are very easy to construct and they are robust electrodes, but they also suffer from some disadvantages. Particularly whenever the electron transfer is slow, it is highly difficult to obtain the E-cell value. There may be a lot of fluctuation while recording the potential difference. You might have observed during the analysis of any solution by potentiometry, there will be a fluctuation, means that is due to the slow kinetics for electron transfer, means the movement of the electrons is not rapid. That means to say that the electrochemical conversion is not spontaneous. The reaction is going to be very slow. So that's what this is framing as an important disadvantage for this particular electrode, slow kinetic for electron transfer. And when you take these metals, while using the metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind, these metals are prone to form the metal oxides at their surface. You'll have a metal and metal ion solution interface. At the interface, there will be chances of formation of surface oxides if the solutions are containing interfering species. So if the interfering species are available, definitely these interfering species will involve in the chemical reaction in order to convert silver oxide, bismuth oxide, cadmium oxide, copper oxide, tin oxide, thallium oxide, and zinc oxide. If oxides are formed, these oxides are normally insoluble in water, insoluble in aqueous solvent. So they will destroy the expected objective of the analysis. They will definitely destroy because the respective oxides are going to be present in the aqueous solution of the sample. So we will not be in a position to accurately determine what is the concentration of silver ion or bismuth ion or cadmium ion and so on and so forth. So whenever performing the potentiometric method of analysis or whenever we are going to perform redox reactions, always we used to maintain acidic conditions. One important problem, very severe problem while maintaining the acidic conditions while using these metallic indicator electrodes is that, say for example, zinc. If zinc is present in the interface of its ionic solution and extreme acidic condition, zinc prone to undergo easy oxidation by the acid. Say for example, nitric acid you consider or sulfuric acid you consider, right? So by the nitric acid or sulfuric acid, zinc prone to undergo oxidation to get converted into zinc oxide. So zinc oxide is a surface oxide which is going to be present in the sample solution where the concentration of zinc 2 plus cannot be determined accurately. So these are the limitations of this metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind. So this is about metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind. Let us move on to metallic indicator electrodes of the second kind. So you know the definition of metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind, in which a metallic electrode M is immersed into metallic ion solution Mn plus, where Mn plus M is called as a redox couple. And this electrode will respond to the concentration of Mn plus. In metallic indicator electrodes of the first kind, this electrode will respond to concentration of only Mn plus, Say for example, if silver electrode is immersed into silver ion solution, then this silver electrode is called as metallic indicator electrode of the first kind. If silver electrode is immersed into silver ion solution, you are going to use this electrode to determine the concentration of silver ion only. In that case, silver electrode is called as metallic indicator electrode of the first kind. So the usual Nernst equation can be written in this manner. For that particular cathodic cell, particular op cell, E is equal to, or E cathode is equal to, E naught of silver 1 silver couple minus 0.05916 into log of 1 over Ag plus concentration. So silver electrode, if you assume this is M, this is going to be M plus, because the charge on silver metal will be only plus 1. So you know from the electrochemical series, you can substitute the standard state potential value for the silver ion silver couple, that is going to be plus 0.7996, and silver ion concentration you can easily determine. Okay, if you assume the aqueous solution of the sample is saturated with silver iodide, the aqueous solution of the sample not only containing silver but it is also containing iodide. So if iodide is present, the aqueous solution will be saturated with silver iodide, because silver iodide is insoluble precipitate and it will become responsible to obtain the saturated solution of silver iodide in the ionic solution of silver ion. If iodide is present, that simply converts the aqueous solution of silver ion to saturated solution of silver iodide. You know the solubility equilibria for silver iodide, which is an insoluble precipitate, it has the tendency to undergo ionization or dissociation to get converted into silver ion and iodide ion. The silver ion and iodide ions are soluble in aqueous medium. Okay, if you write the equilibrium constant expression for this according to law of mass action, because this is simply the dissociation of the insoluble residue, that is AgI, that is precipitate. The equilibrium constant for this reaction is simply the solubility product constant of silver iodide. The equilibrium constant for this reaction, for this dissociation reaction, or for this ionization reaction, is called as the solubility product constant. So the solubility product constant expression for silver iodide can be written as concentration of Ag plus into concentration of I minus. If you simplify for concentration of Ag plus is equal to solubility product constant of silver iodide divided by iodide ion concentration in the saturated solution. So in place of Ag plus ion concentration in this particular equation, in the previous equation what I have showed you, in place of Ag plus ion concentration, you bring this. Ag plus ion concentration is the ratio of the solubility product constant of silver iodide to the iodide concentration in the aqueous solution. So therefore, E is equal to, or E cathode is equal to, plus 0.7996 minus 0.05916 into log of iodide ion concentration divided by solubility product constant of silver iodide. Very simply substituted, the value of Ag plus ion concentration in this equation is substituted by KSP of AgI divided by iodide ion concentration. Okay, if you further simplify, you will get E value is equal to plus 0.07996 minus 0.05916 into log of iodide ion concentration divided by KSP of silver iodide. Just made some rearrangement. So for this particular electrochemical cell, the overall electrochemical cell is containing reference electrode and the indicator electrode. Which is the indicator electrode here? Silver. Silver is immersed into solution of silver iodide and iodide. Where iodide concentration is unknown, we need to determine the concentration of iodide. The concentration of silver iodide cannot be determined because it is present in a saturation level. So for this particular op cell, you can write the Nernst equation, and the overall reaction for this particular electrochemical cell can be written as E cell is equal to K minus 0.05916 into log of concentration of iodide, because the solubility product constant value for silver iodide is also constant. So log of M by N, this is in the form log of M by N, you will get log m minus log n. So 0.05916 into log of iodide concentration minus into minus plus 0.05916 into log of Ksp of AgI. Ksp of AgI. You know Ksp of AgI is constant. 0.05916 into log of Ksp of AgI is also constant. That constant and this value and the liquid junction potential, all of them have been combined together to get a new constant, that is K. So K minus 0.05916 into log of iodide ion concentration. So here, though you are using silver, which is not responding for silver ion, if it responds to silver ion, then it is called as metallic indicator electrode of the first kind. But here, according to this equation, according to this final equation, the potential is directly attributed by the silver electrode with respect to iodide ion concentration. So metallic indicator electrode of the first kind, that is silver electrode, which is used to determine the second species I minus, which is present in the aqueous solution of the sample. I minus is present in the aqueous solution of the sample in the same phase. Comma is present here. So I minus is present in the same phase. So silver electrode has been immersed into iodide ion solution and silver iodide solution, but it is used to determine the concentration of iodide. These type of electrodes are called as metallic indicator electrodes of the second kind. So metallic indicator electrodes of the second kind are nothing but they are the metallic indicator electrodes, but they will respond to the concentration of another species which is in equilibrium with Mn plus. Here Mn plus is silver ion, another species is iodide. Silver ion and iodide combine together to form silver iodide precipitate. Therefore silver electrode is responsible to respond to Mn plus in the metallic indicator electrode of the first kind, but in the second kind this silver ion will respond to iodide. These type of electrodes are called as metallic indicator electrodes of the second kind. So this is the final expression, very important expression, containing the reference electrodes potential, liquid junction potential, and 0.05916 into log of Ksp of AgI.